Hello and welcome to Total Health with Dr. Nick. And if you're new to my channel, my purpose is to inspire, empower, and motivate you to live longer, healthier, and more abundant lives. And I've got a great video today because so many of us, when we go to the grocery store, we want to get the best fruits and vegetables, the best produce for our families. We get home only to find out that what you've purchased is GMO. Now, how many times has that happened to you? You're thinking, I thought I was going to get the best. I went to the store. Everything looked delicious. It looked great. The tomatoes were so red. The cucumbers were so green. But I got GMO instead. Well, guys, today's video is all about how to read the PLU codes. Now, what are PLU codes? PLU codes are price lookup. Price lookup are the different codes that you see on the produce. So we're going to talk about that today so that way you make sure you are getting the best produce for your families. And guys, if you like what we're talking about, make sure you like, you share, you comment, and subscribe. Make sure you click that little bell notification so you get notified anytime I do a video. And if you want to get in the best shape of your life, check out my keto course. I guarantee you it is going to be the best course you find anywhere on the internet. Check out the link below, and we've got everything you need to make sure that you are successful in losing weight, feeling great, and getting the shape of your life. And also too, check out my cookbook down below also. Anyway, guys, so let's go ahead and get started on how to read these PLU codes. Well, first of all, what is a PLU code? Like I said, PLU code means price lookup. And those are those little code numbers you see right on the side. It's a barcode that a lot of times, if you're picking up an avocado or a tomato or any kind of piece of produce, you scan it across and it'll actually read it. Now, this is different than the other kind of barcodes. The other kind of barcodes are your typical barcodes that are the product barcodes, and these typically have the numbers in the beginning are the country of origin, wherever that barcode is from, because these are used all over the world. Then you have different numbers in between that is for the product. So that is not the same. Those are not PLU codes. These are basically barcodes for the product. So how do you then know what these numbers mean? Well, the first ones are four-digit codes. Four-digit codes can either start with a 3 or a 4. Now, what does that mean? Well, if it starts with a 3, it means it's actually been ionized with radiation. So that means it's actually been radiated, and radiation helps to kill bacteria and other microorganisms and things. And we saw this a lot when all of a sudden you couldn't get raw almonds from California anymore. They were all radiated. So if they weren't roasted, they were radiated. Many people were up in arms because we don't want radiated food. We don't want roasted food. We want to make sure that it's raw. That way we're getting all the nutrients. So if you see a number 3 with 3 other numbers, that means it actually has been radiated with ionizing radiation to kill bacteria. So now if you pick up a piece of produce and it has on the PLU code a number 4 followed by 3 other numbers for a total of 4 numbers, that means it's conventionally grown. That means it's using just good old pesticides. So instead of worrying about being GMO, or at least, hey, your body will recognize it, but you may get the toxic chemicals from it. So once again, a 4 with 3 other numbers means it's conventionally grown and sprayed with pesticides. Now here's where we get into 5-digit codes. So if it's a number 8 followed by 4 other digits, okay, so we see that right here, number 8 followed by 4 other digits or 4 other numbers, that means it's GMO. So if you pick up something, and I've done this many times, I'm looking at these certain cucumbers and I'm thinking, wow, these look amazing, only to pick them up and to be disappointed when I see that number 8 in the beginning. So that is a telltale sign that this is GMO and it's something that you don't want to be buying. So once again, genetically modified organism means it's been modified genetically, so that way your body really has a difficult time recognizing it. It's not going to know exactly how to digest it or what to even do with it. And last but not least, the one you're looking for, and that is organic. So what you're going to look for is, once again, a 5-digit code that begins with a number 9 in front. So if it's got a number 9 and then 4 more digits or 4 more numbers on the PLU code, all right, the barcode in the front that you would typically scan, that means that it is organic. Now, in the USDA, okay, US Department of Agriculture, it's required. So if it says it's organic, it has to be organic. I don't know what it's like in other countries around the world, if there's different types of, you know, requirements or so on to be fully organic. But at least in the US, we make sure that if it's says it's USDA organic, it has to be certified organic. So this is what you want to look for when you're looking for food. So if there's any doubt, if you're not sure if it's GMO or if it's good old standard pesticides or anything else, make sure you're at least using number 9 if you can. So number 9 with 4 more digits after that. Now, let's talk about, if you're gonna go organic or inorganic, let's talk about the ones that are the most important to choose that you go with organic, and which ones you can kind of get away with if you go inorganic, and we're calling that the dirty dozen. So in the dirty dozen, there are certain vegetables that you wanna make sure that you go organic with, and why? Because these vegetables are dirty, okay? Very simple. These vegetables are either very porous, have a thin skin, or maybe because they're leafy, they can absorb the pesticides a lot more, or the pesticides stick to it. So the ones that you want to look for as far as the dirty dozen are things like strawberries. And you can just tell by looking at a strawberry, it's full of holes, okay? It's got holes all inside of it where the seeds are embedded. So that can hold pesticides very, very well. Spinach, kale, because once again, it's a leafy green, it's got a lot of surface area to adhere pesticides to. So that's another one that you want to make sure that you're going organic if possible. Things like nectarines and apples, very, very thin skin. Grapes, also thin skin, plus a lot of surface area to a grape to be able to absorb pesticides. Peaches and cherries, same thing, thin skin. Pears, tomatoes, celery, and potatoes. All of these, you want to make sure that you're getting organic because of how well pesticides can adhere to it or absorb into it because of the thin skin. Now, what about the clean 15? Okay, you didn't think we were gonna have a dirty dozen without a clean 15 after that. Well, the clean 15, you have things like avocados. Well, avocados have a thick skin, so it's hard for the pesticides to get in. So you don't necessarily have to get these organic. These are the ones that you can get inorganic and feel pretty good about it. Sweet corn. Pineapple, okay, pineapple once again has a thick skin in it. Sweet corn, you know, it's got the husk around it. Now, for people who are on the keto diet, that's not gonna work, and obviously pineapple's not gonna work, but this is just a general overall video for anybody. So, things like onions have a skin, papaya, very, very thick skin. Sweet peas, if they're frozen, eggplants, asparagus, all have a thicker skin on it. Cauliflower, cantaloupe, broccoli, mushrooms, cabbage, honeydew melon also has a thick skin. You know, if you tried cutting into one of those, you know what I'm talking about. And kiwi also have a pretty thick skin. So these are the ones that you can get away with without having to go organic. But once again, if you can, then certainly go organic. And guys, you know, one thing I want to say is that if you just start to eat cleaner, one of the things that's important to understand, and I'm going to do a video on this also, is that when you have a lot of toxins in your diet, now that could be from your food choices, bad meats, bad fats, bad oils, things like that, or the pesticides that are in your foods, even things like glyphosate, which is a horrible, horrible, you know, destructive to your gut. So that's one of the things you want to stay away from. If you have any kind of gut issues, stay away from things with glyphosate in it. Unfortunately, glyphosate is used in the United States to kill all kinds of, you know, weeds around the food. So glyphosate's horrible. It's basically what we call Roundup in the United States. So this is something to avoid. But the important thing to realize is that these toxic chemicals, when they get in your system, what does your body do? Well, your body tries to protect itself by putting fat around it. So if some of you are not really, you know, losing weight as well as you would like or as fast as you would like, look into your diet. Make sure you clean it up. Get to a cleaner diet so that we have less pesticides, less overall residue, and less toxic load on your body, so that way you can lose weight quickly and get in the shape of your life. So like I said, guys, if you like what we're talking about, make sure you like, share, comment, and subscribe. Make sure, before you go away, in fact, don't go away, make sure you check out my other videos. If you like this one, I'm sure you're gonna love those too. Well, anyway, this is Dr. Nick. I love and appreciate you. God bless, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye-bye.